It being 7:05 on Thursday, February 8th, I call the Finance Committee meeting to order. First item of business would be the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Do we have a follow-up note taker, volunteer?
I don't think there's going to be anything to follow up on today.
Well, just in case.
I'm doing all.
Okay. First item is approval of the minutes from January 11th, 2018. Do I have a motion?
I have a motion to accept the minutes of January 11th, 2018 as written.
Second.
Any discussion?
Are these the revised, did you have a revised minute or there was several, there was a revised one? I never got a copy of it, okay, because I had saw some errors in there. Your motion is to accept as revised?
Yes.
As presented.
Thank you.
I just have one comment. The first line says, under monthly budget, says the TA presented a chart of accounts description which showed the amount originally appropriated, transfers, adjustments, revised budget number, encumbrances, available budget, and percentage used. My recollection is that we just call that the year-to-date budget report. Do we want to just put that in as a notation that it also?
Yeah, because I think at the end that's what we're referring to as documents.
Is the monthly budget.
Yeah. So why don't we just add that in parentheses, monthly budget?
So moved.
Anything else? There being no further discussion, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Abstained? Financial calendar review. I didn't bring it with me.
I have it. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so really, property tax assessment, that's all set.
Right.
And net school spending for next fiscal year, that will, you know, come in February. But we've seen some preliminaries, and there'll be some discussion with the town, and we'll be presented on February 28th. With a proposed budget.
The motor vehicle excise taxes went out in January too. They're supposed to.
And yeah, we should have
that. Is that all that?
Nope.
Next item is follow up from last month. I think. The financial policies you were going to discuss with the Board of Selectmen and also department heads.
Yeah, so.
And present in March, is that?
Right, so it's on the board's agenda for Monday for any discussion, and then it'll be officially adopted in March when they have everyone there.
Okay.
I was see, the chair?
Yeah.
Copy of the, answer from last month from the town administrator this evening. I have a quick question. Maybe, I don't know if it's to you or to Neil. I've been asked several times what the expenses would be for the new library as far as electricity and air conditioning. How much of an increase or decrease is anticipated there?
I have no idea.
Did anybody do a survey on that because of the size of the building?
Not that I'm not aware of anything. Like,
yeah, so we're trying to put together the budget, and we have guesstimated a number based on
square footage
and comparing it to other buildings we have that have similar square footage. So, I mean, it is going to be a definite increase, especially since we're not paying anything.
Well, the size of the building.
Yeah, it's a big building, so.
But we have no idea at the present time.
I mean, I have the kilowatts used on other buildings, and that's what I base it off of, so, yeah.
And there's no heavy equipment, I mean, there's computers and
right. Yeah, and
lights and
they don't, I mean, they're open 13 hours, 12 hours a day.
Do they anticipate, through the chair again, do they anticipate increasing the hours, decreasing the hours, or maintaining the same hours?
Maintaining the same hours.
Because it'll be opening the end of this year, and
right, yeah,
as
so
we prepare the new budget for the coming year, it's factored in. And
yeah, I don't remember the exact number, but I thought it was 30,000-ish that I just have as a placeholder. Just I want to make sure that we have enough.
This
seems
is
like a lot of money.
You're on that committee over there, right?
No, I'm
you're,
not.
You're
I'm
a liaison.
I just sit in on it.
Why can't we decrease some hours during the week and open a half a day on Sunday for the kids to do their homework or come in and use the computers? There are libraries throughout the United States now that are open on Sundays. If we have to have a library, why not make it convenient for everybody?
That's not up to me to decide.
Yeah, so certainly that's an option. That's going to cost us more money, and Sunday would be double time, but
not if it's built into the salary structure and the job description. It wouldn't
for a union.
If you have to work Sunday, maybe Monday would be your time and a half day, or Tuesday.
Yeah, I mean, we could look into it, and you'd have to negotiate the position working on Sunday, and you'd say, yeah, you get these days off instead. I mean, it's possible. It'll cost more money. I'm not looking to spend more money right now.
No, but is there a way we can do a survey of the town to find out if anybody does want it, if it's a necessity or not a necessity?
That's, yeah, we could definitely see how much interest there would be on opening on Sunday.
And I think it's hard to predict because there's going to be so many new endeavors within a big, thriving library that's unanticipated right now. I mean, you can only anticipate it.
Yeah.
But I think, you know, as we get into this first year of occupancy in FY19, we'll have a much better flavor on how the town reacts to it and how we need to respond to the town, or how the library committee needs to respond to the town. It's all well and good for discussion now, but I think we should, you know, stay focused on getting it open. So let's move on to follow-up from last month. I'm sorry, for the monthly budget.
So I thought I had attached that to the email. I did not. So, but I did send out the summary of areas that we have issues with and areas that we are looking pretty good at.
I think the report that you, the letter, that you, the email that you sent, pretty much describes the deficits and the surpluses, and I think the important thing are that one counterbalances the other right now, so we're not in any particular extraordinary circumstance or anything, right? Things are, you know, some high, some low.
Roughly where they should be.
Yeah. So any questions on the budget year-to-date through January?
Can we just go over the comment on the snow and the ice?
What did I say? So right now, so the original budget is $155,000, and we're $90,000 over that.
That's as of now, right?
Yeah, well, I mean,
to the chair.
Less today's cleanup, yeah. But I think they also got enough salt for the, and they used some today.
Right, so did I put that in there?
Yeah, you put salt purchases will last us the rest of the season.
Right, yeah, so there was $70,000 worth of salt recently purchased, so.
So that's.
That cost won't be happening again.
And that's included in that $90,000?
So last year, we ended up being $310,000.
So double.
$310,000. I think we're gonna be about there again.
And that'll come out of?
Well, we'll see if we can cover with whatever money's left over, but I expect some free cash.
Anything else on that letter? Okay, anything back on the budget? And that was a snapshot of this, correct? Your email, your.
Yeah, I mean, this, I wrote this the end of January, and this is January 25th or something, and this is actually January 31st.
Okay. No catastrophes in those 5 days. Nobody, does anybody have any question on the budget?
I don't.
We'll move on. Old business, the library building project update?
Yeah, I have nothing. There has not been a meeting since our last meeting. The next meeting is scheduled for next week, Tuesday, 5 p.m. But everybody can see the more windows are going in. They're still behind on some of them. 3739 Nigger Street is torn down. They're starting to clear that area out.
It looks like they've graded it too.
Yes. Unless Doug has any further updates at this point.
Okay.
Not until our next meeting will I have anything new from the library building committee meeting.
Very good.
I know Doug sent out, this is going to be kind of hard to see, but this is a breakdown. Pass this around. A breakdown of the 3739 Nigger Street property budget.
Are those copies?
Those are copies. You can pass those around to them.
Yeah. So certainly, that little project became more expensive than we were expecting. Couple of things that the relocation was more than I anticipated. Hazardous materials which ended up being more. Tearing down the buildings ended up being more. So then when you add in the contingency, I don't have the numbers right. What's the total number?
That was 33,000, right? Not 53,000. 33,000.
For the contingency? Get that one right.
Let me go over what we have here. I know my copies didn't come out very good, but hazmat was 60,000.
Yeah.
this down towards the bottom there, these handwriting notes, handwritten notes, hazmat, $60,000. Relocation was $44,000. Additional contingency, that's $33,000, right?
That is $33,000, yep.
Purchase, $15,000, and construction cost is $194,000.
Now, has...
Those are the cost overruns.
Has anything been said about the original plan with the wall to reduce, get those costs back?
Oh, yeah, so I contacted our attorneys and we did an analysis and really they didn't think there was much chance to go after the architect for any breach of contract, so we haven't aggressively pursued that because we didn't think we had a very good case. So they were working on the data that they had available at the time. That's just what happens sometimes.
Yeah. So will the line items for the building material for that wall won't be used?
Right.
So those line
items. Right. Yeah. So that will bring this down.
Yeah. That.
Right.
Has that been calculated? I guess is what.
Oh, that I.
If you're not buying all that walls and you're not grading that.
Right. So this is just the cost for that. There's the savings from not having to do the original wall.
Will be in the other budget, right?
Yeah. I did have those numbers set over. Remember them. If you want, we can get those estimates.
Yeah. Be good.
So, Mr. Chair,
yeah.
This could be just my naiveness, but have we looked at any of these contracts in fixed bid rather than time and materials? And is that even possible?
Yeah, no, they are. Most of them were actual bids, like the hazardous materials and the relocation, the demolition, that are actual bids.
Fixed bids?
Any other questions on the library? Move on to the water treatment plant. Second meeting was Tuesday. We're still in the pre-construction phase, gathering permits and working with National Grid and Mass Electric to coordinate them. They're free thinkers, they do it when they want. So the upshot of that meeting was that things are on track. It doesn't look like anything will be on site until probably early March, maybe the end of February. They'll be putting a construction trailer out there and begin assessing and marking off wetlands and, you know, preparing for the spring. The thing that I should note is they're looking at cost savings because we know that, you know, the final was higher than what we estimated. So they are looking at cost savings along the way, and some of the things that they've talked about was the piping to the pumping stations was originally designed to go in the roadway, so it'd be tar and all that. They're going to move it off to the side of the road, so there'll be a savings there. Looking at changing the copper downspouts and gutters from copper to aluminum. And there's some conduits that were installed in the 90s instead, and they're going to assess them when they open ground, but if they can reuse the existing conduits and runs, they'll do that. So every step of the way, I guess the upshot is they're looking to, you know, minimize expenses. And
one of the other more minor ones was the original contract had they need to provide the chemicals to start the place, and we're like, well, we'll just buy them ourselves and not get your markup on it. So.
Yeah.
The wetland delineation should not begin until after April or May, because The only way to determine.
No, but they gotta take pictures, they gotta take pictures.
Vegetation.
I know, but I'm just saying they're gonna start marking off and they're gonna, they gotta take pictures of the ground before they touch it and after they start.
In other words, they're gonna pre-cook the bread before they cook it.
Yeah.
Okay.
And the project timeline is the start date, the notice to proceed was in January. The contract called for a 550-day substantial completion. That brings it to early July of 2019. And final completion is late August. That's the 600-day final. So I think that's all. For now. So that'll be exciting to get that started. It'll be more exciting to get it finished. The status of the draft financial policies.
So we've mentioned that the board will review it Monday and next.
Yeah. And nothing more from the department heads or all that. So it's basically just the board at this point. Nobody on this committee has any further questions.
Yeah, I believe I sent it to everyone beginning of January.
Yeah.
Have you made any comments or additional comments?
Next item is approval of the town audit committee. That was brought to the Board of Selectmen and they agreed that it would be a subcommittee of the finance committee. And they appointed Randy Becker as their representative on that committee. Have we heard anything on the audit?
Yeah, he is expecting it beginning of March.
Beginning of March?
He was waiting for the single audit to be completed. He had done all his draft financials, so.
Okay.
Is there
a reason it's dragging?
No, I mean, typically you get it February-ish.
So. Right, right. Yeah. Next item is the FY19 preliminary budget update.
Yeah, so I gone through, analyzed the revenue, and I've taken everyone's requests for what they want from the budget, and that number came to just over $1 million in the deficit. When I cut out some of the things that I don't think are necessary, I still have a roughly $500,000 deficit. So looking at all sorts of different options to close that, including health insurance reform, adjusting some of the fees, and pinching pennies anywhere we can find them.
Yeah, we've been working on the fees. It's not much, but it's a good exercise to see where we stand on our fees compared to other towns. So we've done that, and pretty much in line for the most part. There's some fees that we are recommending bumping up. It's not going to amount to $500,000, but it will keep us on par with other fees. We're also asking to look at potential for other fees. A lot of towns charge fees for things that we don't charge, massage parlors, what am I calling?
Nail salons.
Nail salons.
Parlors.
Yeah, that sort of thing. Also, other, food items, things that should be inspected, vending machines with food, we're going to look at that, see if, that needs to be inspected. So.
To the chair.
Yeah.
How about insurance on buildings in town of Webster? are we ensuring all of our own buildings and not some that are, how would I put it, mutually understood that they could use it on our property but not pay taxes or insurance on it?
I'm not sure what you're referring to, but I went through the schedule of what is on the insurance and they're all town.
We can't save any money there at all.
Well, I don't even have the exact quote back from the insurance company, but last year we, the year before I got here, the town rebid out the insurance, so I feel like it's a good number and we're giving a fair price for our insurance.
There is a possibility if we go every year to our insurance carrier, there's a possibility we could save money there.
Yeah, and I was approached by an insurance company and they said, give me your statement of values, and so I gave it to them, and if they come back with a cheaper price, so yeah, we'll look into it.
It's all we can do.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Anything else on the budget?
I was gonna say, just on the fees, our philosophy is we want those who are using the services to pay for the services, and we want the fee to cover the cost of the employee to provide that service.
Yeah.
Makes sense.
You know, if it's a $10 or $15 charge, but it takes an on-site visit or maybe a revisit, that should at least be captured. And oh, yeah?
You agreed with it.
Yeah. So I think, you know, there's work to be done on the budget, but there are some big things that have to be tackled to get a balanced budget this year.
If any of you are friends with the governor, you can ask him to give us more money.
Do you think there'll be possibly, I mean, everybody's talking about the January, February, December numbers for the state looking good.
Yeah, they're looking good. So they did increase local unrestricted aid by the 3.5%, which is what they were expecting state revenue to grow at. But our portion of Chapter 70 was only like a 2% increase. So yeah, the $1.3 million budget, they increased by 3.5%, but the $12 million one, they only increased by 2%.
You know, if we ran our own lottery in the town of Webster, we'd be millionaires already. We give enough to the state.
Keep pushing for that betting track. next item, FY19 capital update. I don't think, do you have anything to report? I know
we met, but and I requested some additional information. I haven't gone to take the tour of the vehicles they want to replace at DPW because it snows every day.
Did you bring your camera?
I will when I go, yeah.
Okay.
We should set a time though, and then we set a meeting, then I will for sure do it by then.
Chair, if you would like help with that, I do take pictures of photography stuff.
You know how to take pictures?
Pardon?
You know how to take pictures then?
Very nice
seen
pictures.
Very nice pictures, yes.
I have seen them.
Any feedback on the three quotes?
That's just going to be the plan, so I have got any pushback.
Do you have any expectation on when to call them in?
I emailed him, so we're trying to set up time next week.
Okay. All right. On to new business. Status of the accounting department.
So I did the initial round of interviews with the potential candidates. And next Tuesday, we have an interview panel with two members of the Board of Selectmen and the chair of the finance committee and myself. My top two candidates that I'm recommending.
And they're both viable
candidates. They're both viable, they are known throughout the municipal finance world, and they have good reputations.
And things are running okay?
So right now, yeah, the interim is coming in 2 days a week. The day-to-day stuff's getting done. Actually, the current staff is doing a great job keeping on top of all that stuff. And their interim is diving into some of the issues that we've had and trying to at least get the ball rolling so that they can hand it off to the new person.
Is the financial team meetings still occurring?
Yeah, so we met last Tuesday. Not this week yet, so we meet every other Tuesday. And the DOR has been and will continue to attend those. Actually, some good news that we looked at our debt, and there's a couple of bonds that are callable, so they're older than 10 years. So we asked our financial advisor to do an analysis and see if we took these out to, if we refinanced these, refunded them, what kind of savings would there be? And over the remaining term of the contract or the debt, it would be like a $250,000 savings. So those are the projects in that refunding would be some of the school ones that were debt exclusions, and then a lot of water and sewer ones. So it actually doesn't help the general fund at all because they're enterprise funds or they were debt excluded projects, but it will bring down taxes and water and sewer rates, what would be needed to fund those projects.
And that was unanticipated when the rates were set for water sewer.
Right, yeah. I mean, it's $250,000 over 10 years,
it's not gonna be,
so it's not a lot of money.
Yeah.
Through the chair, so we're not looking to extend the term on those, just the rate.
Yeah. So, because what we are trying to do is go through the Municipal Finance Oversight Board, which is a way to use the state's bond rating instead of our own, which is a little better, so the interest rate would be a little bit lower, and interest rates are just better than when we initially issued those.
Is there any update on the Park Ave School, the unsettled?
No.
Is that hurting us as we?
No, the cash flow wise, it's not an issue. So they're just trying to come up with a resolution that doesn't involve a lot of legal fees. So.
Longer it takes, though, the legal fees go up, no?
Yeah. So.
Right.
Through the chair, just a question with the accounting. If you go forward as one of the two candidates, are they going to start at the beginning of next fiscal year, or are they going to start prior?
So they would start prior, because they'd be less than paying the interim, or about the same. So
is it going to be the same on the current salary?
Well, so we're going to have a deficit there anyway because we're still paying out the account. So I don't know what the exact salary will be, but it'll be in the ballpark of what the current account's making.
And I think the idea is to get an accountant on board as soon as we can.
Sooner is better.
Yeah.
Because we're paying the company a much higher hourly rate than
right.
we would replace
it. And we're keeping that to a minimum just to get the work done. Next item was the SWCC FY19 budget. I understand they met today and they did approve a final.
Yeah, I'll pass it around if you want.
Budget.
Through the chair, can I just go back to the status of the accounting department and just ask, would it benefit us to have both the consultant and a new person there at the same time for a period of time?
Yeah, there will be a transition, right? Because they've been doing the work, and it would be a waste of the work they've done if there's no one there to explain what they have done.
Yeah.
So, I don't know if you recall, but the SWIP budget was amended at town meeting because we got an additional grant last. So we amended in August, we found out about the grant in July or something. So this is, at the bottom there, you see a 5.1% increase and 4.6% increase. So that's from the amended budget to the proposed FY19 budget. So the local appropriation is going up 5.1%, the total overall budget is 4.6%. So if we look at what we budgeted last year, it's roughly $100,000 less than the original budget approved for FY18.
That's good.
And there's no no movement on adding, looking to add.
We've been in negotiations with a lot of other towns.
Nothing serious.
So last year the original budget was $351,000, and this year it's $263,000.
So. Okay, I think I have no information on mail other than I sent out that DLS email. I don't know if you had a chance to look at it, but it had some good information to the town and sort of a good litmus test in certain areas. So that's good information. I don't know if is that any opportunity to put that on the town website or anything?
Yeah, we can put a link to it. Actually, so there's a company that takes all that data and makes it pretty.
Yeah.
And
like the school department?
The school department. The same company. So they called me and was like, I'm not paying for that. But then there is this grant that they said, oh, if we sign your name to it and you get it, will you let us do that? Sure.
Good question, please.
So I can put a link to the DLS website,
yeah,
and so people can know that it's there and there are opportunities.
Okay.
So,
okay.
Yeah.
Good. Yeah.
Grant writer. We are anticipating ever getting a grant writer for the town website.
Yes, you're paying me.
Excuse me?
I'm the grant writer.
Well, you can't keep up with everything, neither can
No, it's
we
true.
We should have somebody there that can get a percentage of the grants that they write. There's a lot out there. You hear about them every day, other towns, other cities, other states getting them. Mm-hmm. It might be, you know, you've got a load on your shoulders that I wouldn't want on mine for all the rice in China.
There's
a lot of rice there.
Can we look at getting interns? Because I know that this is the kind of stuff that
they would do. Actually, that is a good idea. We had an intern last summer, but now it's probably a good time to try to find one for the upcoming summer.
Were they from Nichols? So?
No, it was in Connecticut.
No.
I can't remember the name.
To the chair one more time. He mentioned Nichols. I do know their financial department there, if approached, would have a team come to town and work diligently through the course of the year with the town. They did it with private businesses in town and got them out of holes with the federal government, with the Small Business Association. It might be something you could look into.
Yeah, connecting their resources with local business owners, is that what you mean?
Yeah, they went to work for the small business and they stopped mortgage payments and interest and penalties for a period of time till a report was written out on the disposition of the companies. So it might be good for to see if you can get them to come in and help with grant writing or going to different departments to see what the departments need and what's out there for them. It's worth a shot.
Yeah, so the state has a grant portal where you can go on and supposedly all the state grants are listed there. And there are a lot that...
But that would be good for an intern.
Yeah, to at least go through and be like, okay, this was due this time last year and don't miss it this year. Make sure you...
I mean, we have a financial institution in,
yeah,
of education. It might not be a bad idea engage them.
And I know Clark has a MPA program, and they sometimes are looking for people that want to go into the public sector.
Yeah. Wouldn't
hurt. Crazy as they may be.
Okay, there's nothing else. Next meeting, February 22nd. We agreed to meet.
February 22nd?
Yeah, 2 weeks, every 2 weeks.
I won't be in.
Okay.
And the main agenda is discussion of the 19 budget, correct?
Yeah. I think we should have a good idea. I mean, the 28th is the deadline per the charter, but I think we'll have a pretty good... did you have a question? Nick?
I didn't know if you said there was a meeting on the 28th also. Just the 22nd, right?
Just the 22nd. I was saying the 28th is the deadline for...
The school...
Per the charter for the budget to be in, the preliminary budget.
Do we know when the tri-meeting is going to be? Is that in March?
No, that's, you're going to, the
we'll be,
Jen probably is going to coordinate that.
Yeah, if there's a good chance I will be able to work out a balanced budget with the school committee and or the superintendent. So there may not be much to talk about.
Motion to adjourn?
Second. I know, why?
Motion, a second. Any discussion? Meeting adjourned. That's the timeliest meeting
that's
in a long time. Thank you.
Small
Can I have the blanks?
Oh, sorry.